Greetings, everyone. Thank you for lending an ear to The Voice of the Times for Friday, December 4, 2020. For today's editorial, criminalizing red tagging is a bridge too far and unnecessary. Lest he dig himself deeper into a patent hole in the head, we would like to warn Senator Panfilo Lacson about his latest brainstorm of making red tagging a crime in our country. Last Wednesday, Lacson said he was seriously considering proposals to make red tagging a crime after he led a Senate inquiry into the alleged propensity of military officers to tag government critics as communists. In a message to reporters, he said, "I am seriously considering the recommendation to criminalize red tagging as long as such legislation will not infringe on the Bill of Rights involving freedom of speech and expression." Lacson led a series of Senate hearings that looked into the alleged red tagging by military officials of organizations and lawmakers belonging to the Makabayan Congressional Bloc. This new advocacy of his looks perplexing to us because for a long time, Lacson has been known as a law and order and right-wing politician who was presumably anti-communist. But now here he is, surfacing as a defender of the rights of left-wing individuals and organizations from being branded or baited by the military as communists or reds, suggesting that they are out to overthrow our duly constituted government. How will Senator Lacson and his fellow legislators proceed to criminalize red tagging? What will constitute the crime? Will the mere labeling by the military, the police, or a government department of an individual or organization as communist or supporter of the Communist Party of the Philippines, New People's Army, or the CPP-NPA be regarded as an act of red tagging? Will personal name calling be similarly actionable? How will Congress differentiate red tagging as more reprehensible than labeling citizens as a Christian or Protestant or any sectarian or a Nazi or a terrorist? The truth is that red tagging is one of those ideas that appeared to vanish in a flash with the end of the Cold War in 1989 and the collapse of the Soviet Union and the so-called Iron Curtain. A much earlier similar term to it is red baiting or McCarthyism. According to Wikipedia, red baiting is an informal logical fallacy that seeks to discredit the validity of a political opponent and the opponent's logical argument by accusing, denouncing, attacking, or persecuting the target individual or group as anarchist, communist, Marxist, socialist, Stalinist, or sympathetic to these ideologies. The word baiting refers to persecution, torment, or harassment. In the United States, red baiting is more famously associated with McCarthyism, when politicians like Senator Joseph McCarthy publicly accused individuals and officials of being communist. McCarthyism became a contemptible tactic in U.S. politics and is often decried by its victims, yet America never bothered to criminalize McCarthyism or red baiting. We will look ludicrous before the world if we blindly follow Senator Lacson into criminalizing red tagging. The nation, of course, has been fighting a communist insurgency for nearly 60 years. We are one country that still faces today a live communist insurgency. Red tagging has become a tool in the conflict as our military has used it in the fight against the CPP-NPA. In the 21st century, red baiting does not have quite the same effect it previously did due to the fall of most Marxist-Leninist governments. Why should red tagging be more offensive? Senator Francis Pangilinan says criminalizing red tagging is worth looking into because of the alleged penchant of the state to red tag political dissenters. There must be complementary accountability for such acts that could constitute abuse of authority, political bias, and disregard for free exercise of views, he said in a statement. Red-tagged individuals have also become the target of killings, harassment, and threats. And the impunity persists because no one is punished for such acts, he said. Senate President Vicente Sotto III has suggesting the filing of libel cases instead of criminalizing red-tagging. He recognizes that criminalizing red-tagging at this time would be difficult to do. It's not only difficult, it's a foolish project for the legislature to engage in. Criminalize red tagging? we might as well criminalize also fear-mongering during a pandemic. And that's the editorial for Friday, December 4, 2020. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to its digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and listen to the voice of the times.